it's been 50 years. It's hard for me to believe that. It seems like just a couple of weeks ago to me, because things were impressed so much at the time. The experiences of the flight have been recalled so often since that time.
Mercury astronaut John Glenn returned to NASA's Kennedy Space Center for a weekend of celebrations marking 50 years of Americans in orbit. During the event, Glenn and fellow Mercury astronaut Scott Carpenter, the second American to orbit the planet, told crowds of current workers, news media members, and a couple of today's astronauts about their adventures.
Would your eyeballs change shape? That was one of the concerns. And the little miniature eye chart is still on Friendship 7 up there in the Smithsonian in Washington.
There were a lot of unknowns in the early days of space flight. Some turned out to be important, some turned out to be unimportant.
Glenn made three orbits of Earth during his mission on February 20th, 1962. Carpenter followed 3 months later with a similar mission that continued to prove that people could operate in orbit. With those fledgling steps completed, the space agency continued making large strides into space, including the giant leaps to the surface of the moon 7 years after Glenn began America's orbital exploration. Glenn and Carpenter undertook different adventures following their flights. Glenn served in the U.S. Senate, while Carpenter charted a new career researching the underwater world. Glenn returned to NASA in 1998 for a research mission aboard Space Shuttle Discovery on STS-95 that lasted more than 8 days. By comparing his body's reactions to microgravity with information from his first years with NASA, scientists could better judge some aspects of the aging process. For both Mercury astronauts, their flights of the 1960s opened an era of space exploration that continues to inspire Americans and produce technological innovations on Earth.
And what have we done in the space program? We have 16 nations working together, the biggest cooperative international program ever put together anytime in the International Space Station.